When I was a kid back in the 1960s, I used to come home from school and watch Batman, the real Batman, with Adam West. The Batmobile was my first car crush.
That's right.
Welcome to the best day in that 8-year-old kid's life. Gosh. Hold on.
Okay.
Oops.
The doors can be a little sticky.
All right.
But check out the options. Oil spreader, smoke screen, bat chute. None of this stuff works, of course. Never did. I'm just amazed it's still here. And gotta love the neon paint job. This was the groovy Batmobile.
Then these days, when people think of Batman, you think dark, brooding, emotional baggage.
Stop smiling. It's not a joke.
Need some therapy.
You have my permission to die.
I like my Batman.
Holy sardine!
The 60s TV Batman was, frankly, really uptight.
Precisely, Robin.
But he was so serious, it was funny. He was totally in on the joke. And so was his car. The Bat turn lever? Come on.
Prepare Batcopter for immediate takeoff.
Batmobile approaching Batcopter.
Bat drift angle.
Drop Bat ladder.
The TV series went on the air in 1966, but the car that would become the Batmobile was originally a 1955 Lincoln concept car, the Futura. George Barris, the same guy who made the Munster coach, the Beverly Hillbillies car, and lots more TV freakmobiles, turned it into the Batmobile. And while there were others made for the show, he says this is the one and only original. Now that the show has been in reruns for decades, its hero car is no longer in top crime-fighting shape. Neither am I. But the big Ford V8 engine is still strong, and even though you never heard it on the show, it sounds damn good. The brakes? Well, those could barely stop a Bat shopping cart.
The visibility out of this car is literally like looking out of a fishbowl. I bet Batman never had to pass inspection, though.
Also, one switch you won't see in here? Bat air conditioning.
Holy convection oven, Batman. It is hot in here. This is the most expensive car I have ever driven by at least a couple of million dollars.
In 2013, George Barris sold this car at auction to an Arizona collector for a total of $4.6 million. Now this guy has decided it's his turn to sell. He wants $5 million.
When I think about this day, I'm not going to remember the asking price. I'm going to remember that I drove the car that Batman drove.
Robin, the Bat crowbar, please.